Today I came up with a new topic, square root. I will explain you only perfect square root and decimal square root. In my next video, I will explain you non-perfect square root. Before going to that method, you have to understand one concept. That is, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25. 6 square is 36, 7 square is 49, 8 square is 64, 9 square is 81. And if you say it carefully, 1 square and 9 square ending digit is 1. Similarly, for 2 and 8 square ending digit is 4, 3 and 7 square ending digit is 9, 4 and 6 square ending digit is 6, 5 square ending digit is 5. Now we will go to the method. First, I will take one example. 529. First, we have to separate this. In right hand side, we have to keep 2 digit, and the remaining digit we have to keep in left hand side. Here, the right hand side ending digit is 9. If ending digit is 9, we will get 3 or 7. 7. This we will get in the units place. In the left hand side, the number is 5. 5 is in between of 2 square and 3 square. 2 square is less than 5, so that we have to write 2 in the tens place. 2. Now, how we have to choose the correct answer in between of this 2 number. Here we have to leave the unit space, and the remaining number is 2. So that we have to do 2 into its next number 3. 2 into 3 is 6. Here 5 is less than 6, so that we have to take the smaller option, 23. Square root of 529 is 23. Now I will take one more example. That is 9409. First we have to separate this. In right hand side we have to keep 2 digit, and the remaining digit we have to keep in left hand side. Here the right hand side ending digit is 9. If ending digit is 9, we will get 3 or 7 in the units place. And 9. In left hand side, the number is 94. Here 94 is in between of 9 square and 10 square is 100. So 94 is in between of 9 square and 10 square. 9 square is 81, and 9 square is less than 94. So that we have to take 9 square because it is less than 94. And 9 will be in the tens place. Now here also we have to leave the unit place, and here the remaining number is 9. So that we have to do 9 into its next number 10. 9 into 10 is 90. 94 is more than 90, so that we have to take the higher option, 97. Square root of 9409 is 97. Now I will take one more example. That is 15376. First we have to separate this. In right hand side we have to keep 2 digit, and the remaining digit we have to keep in left hand side. Here right hand side ending digit is 6. If ending digit is 6, we will get 4 or 6 in the units place. In left hand side the number is 153. 12 square is 144. 13 square is 169. I have memorize this. If you didn't have memorized, you can use the method which I have explained you earlier. 153 is in between of 12 square and 13 square. 12 square is less than 153, so that we have to take 12 because it is less than 153. Now, how we have to choose the correct answer from these two options? First, we have to leave the unit place and the remaining digit is 12, so that we have to do 12 into its next number 13. 12 into 13 is 156. 153 is less than 156, so that we have to take the smaller option, 124. Square root of 15,376 is 124. Now I will move to decimal square root. First I will take one example. 94.09. You know the answer of 9409. It is 97. Now where the decimal will come? Here the decimal is 2 from right hand side. So in answer it will be half from right hand side. Then it will be 1 from right hand side. The answer will be 9.7. Now if the decimal is in odd figure, what we have to do? First we have to bring the decimal in even figure. So it will be 94.09. And we have to multiply with 10. Because here we are moving the 0.1 from right hand side. You know the answer of 94.09. It is 9.7. We have to multiply 9.7 into square root of 10. 9.7. Square root of 10 is 3.16. We have to do 9.7 into 3.16. Then we will get the answer. This is the method of doing square root easily. If you like this video, please subscribe my YouTube channel, Anushka Mathematician. Stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.